great.
You look wonderful. Everything's going well?
It's been 5 years. Yeah, I know, and it's amazing.
5 years without a return of one of the deadliest cancers, pancreatic.
My brother passed away within 6 months. And when I was diagnosed, I thought, this is it. I really did. I did not expect to be here now.
74-year-old John Davis and his wife Wilma are still together, in part because of this huge machine, which delivers radiation with surgical precision and is part of one of the world's leading programs in something called radiosurgery.
I like to call bloodless surgery. It has the ability to target tumors in places in the body that would not have been traditionally available or accessible to a surgeon.
Not getting any extra dose of the spinal cord or the esophagus.
The surgical precision is achieved with futuristic 3D models of where the radiation beams must go. And the teamwork of the surgeon, in this case thoracic surgeon Neil Christie, and Dr. Heron, the patient has lung cancer.
You can see other structures like the heart, you have the lungs themselves, and the esophagus that we all want to protect from the high doses of radiation.
Dr. Christie and Dr. Heron both agree surgery is still the gold standard for cancers like lung and pancreas, unless the cancer has spread or...
If you have a cancer that's localized in one spot, often we'll operate on those patients, but sometimes patients have other health problems, advanced age, severe lung disease, that might not make them candidates for a safe operation.
In the case of John Davis, surgery came first. Then he had this radio surgery to zap the cancer still remaining on an artery on his pancreas. There were no side effects from the targeted radiation.
When it was done, I told my wife and my home, they didn't do anything. I said, there's nothing. And I had no after effects at all.
I'm not even sure he even experienced any tiredness from it.
But it killed the cancer that was inoperable.
It did.
There is hope. There really is hope, and there are lots of things and lots of technology, and frankly, the teams that are available to really make a difference, even for the most challenging, inaccessible tumors.
Now, John Davis mm-hmm. did have 6 months of chemotherapy at the very end of it. He said that actually was the worst part of the treatment.
Oh, I can hear that, yeah.
But it's what's amazing is that there are all kinds of different ways that they now can get to these inaccessible tumors. This is the not invasive at all. There are some others that are minimally invasive. One's called a nano knife. It's not done in this region. It's done at Sloan Kettering and the University of Maryland. But just check with your doctors.